Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick coming to you from the Philippines. God bless all you guys. I'm way behind in the videos that the Lord has given me to do, you know, and I just want you to pray with you right now. Let's pray together, brothers and sisters. Now, the right people that need to see this video, I want to pray that they're going to see this. This is a video for those who'll be left behind, particularly for Israelites, Jewish people, Israeli people, the children of Israel, and then also for Gentiles who are left behind. Let's pray together. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Most High God, Creator of heaven and earth, hallelujah, hallowed be thy name, Lord. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, Lord, in your church as it is in heaven. Blessed be the name of the Lord, hallelujah. Praise his holy name, for he is worthy of all praise and glory. He is righteous and highly exalted. Hallelujah. Bless his precious name. Hallelujah. Father, we honor you. We praise you. We worship you. Lord, we lift your name on high. Hallelujah. Bless your glorious name. For you are the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise you, God, creator of heaven and earth. Hallelujah. Bless you, Lord. Oh, my soul, and all that is within me. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord, oh, my soul, and all that is within me. For you healeth all of our diseases and forgiveth us of all of our sins, Lord, as you said in your word, Psalm 103. Blessed be the name of the Lord, God Most High. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Lord, for the stone that the builders rejected has become the head of the corner, Lord. And it is marvelous in our eyes. We praise you, Father, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Brothers and sisters, may the peace of the Lord be upon you today. Bless his holy name, for he is righteousness and justice. Hallelujah. For the word says righteousness and justice are the foundations of his throne. He is the soon coming king for us, brothers and sisters. And brothers and sisters, as we are about to depart out of this world, even as our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and Lord is just speaking to me. Lord has given me so many messages, brothers and sisters. And now he just gave me something totally new. Listen, brothers and sisters, in John, I'm laughing because it wasn't what I was going to say. In John chapter 12, 13, and along in there, it says when, I believe it's the beginning of John chapter 13, when it says the Lord was about to depart out of this world, he loved his own even until the end. And it says in that text that some Greeks came to him, some Gentiles, some Goyim, some people from the nations. They came to meet Jesus. See, it was time for the Gentiles to come in. But the Lord's like, as soon as he found out, he said he groaned in his spirit. And he said, Father, glorify your name. And then he heard the sound from heaven. Some heard the sound. Some heard thunder. This is a whole nother message right there. Some people could hear the voice of God. Some people sounded like thunder. Some people said an angel spoke to him. But God spoke to him from heaven. See, there's people at all those different levels, and that's a whole other message. The sister, I won't say your name, who's doing those nuggets and putting it together for me, that's a good one right there. Anyway, so people here at different levels, but the Lord, the Father said to the Son, there is one God, and then there's one what and three who's. One Godhead. Three within the Godhead, God the Father, God the Son, the Holy Ghost. So here is God the Son, and God the Father spoke from heaven and said, I've glorified it, I will glorify it again. It's not my message. My message to you is Jesus, when he heard, when they came to him, one of his disciples came and said, some Greeks that want to see you, some Gentiles. Jesus groaned within his spirit, see, because Israel had to first reject him, the Bible says. Jesus said, I must first be rejected by this generation. And Israel rejected him. Therefore, the Gentiles came in. Read Romans chapter 9 through 11. We see that because of their rejection of Christ, because of their blindness, we've been grafted in. It goes on to say in Romans chapter 11, you know, if their being cast away is the reconciling of the nations, the Gentile, the Goyim, who just like who came to see Jesus, how much more will their restoration be? Brothers and sisters, just as Jesus was about to depart out of this world, and he groaned in his spirit when the Gentiles wanted to see him because he knew that he was going to be rejected by the Jews. He knew that the time was there and it was another confirmation that the time of his crucifixion was at hand because the Gentiles were eager to get the word. to get the gospel. And that gospel couldn't be given to them until he was first rejected and crucified and condemned to death by his own people, by the nation of Israel. He came into his own, and his own knew him not. John chapter 1, but to as many as receive him, to those who believe on his name, to him he gave power to become the sons of God. John chapter 1, praise God. As John the Baptist said, here he is, the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. Yeshua, HaMashiach, Jesus the Messiah. So, brothers and sisters, the message that the Lord just gave me, which was not the message I was going to give, was this. That as the church is about to depart out of the world, we heard, hey, in these last days, there's lots of Israelites, who most of you guys call Jews. That's one tribe of Israel. There's 12 tribes. One of them is Judah, but people who practice Judaism, they call them Jews. It's also true, the religion of Judaism. But it's time that they're coming in. There is a remnant of Israelites who got saved. Throughout the time, as the Bible tells, there's just a remnant. But the day's coming, brothers and sisters, when 144,000 Israeli men, 12,000 from all those tribes, minus Dan, and Joseph gets a double portion, Ephraim and Manasseh, just as his father, Jacob, who aka also Israel, laid hands on his sons and gave them the blessing that they received the double portion. Those 144,000 Israelites are going to come to the Lord. And that's what the videos that the Lord has given me for Israelism, for them. For those 144,000 mighty men of valor, mighty men of God, who will come forth, hallelujah, and bring glory to his name, those sons of God, hallelujah, that will bring about the revival of the nation of Israel. And also, by the grace of God, there'll be a remnant. This is, hear the word of the Lord. There will be, people talk about what they see in Revelation, all those people that's gone on to be with the Lord. That is true, brothers and sisters. And people read those numbers in Revelation, try to mix them up. That's the church. That's not the church. That's the tribulation saints. That's all these false interpretations. It's up to each individual one of us to get right with God. Get right with God. Jesus said to us in Luke chapter 1, 21, verse 36, talking about the tribulation period. And he said at the end of explaining the tribulation, he said, therefore, watch always and pray that you be kind of worthy to escape these things and stand before the Son of Man. Revelation 3:10, Jesus speaking to the church of Philadelphia, saying, because you have patiently kept my word. Because you have patiently kept my word. Not because you said a sinner's prayer. Because thou hast patiently kept my word. I will keep you out of the hour of trial that will come on the whole earth and try all those that dwell on the earth. A.K.A. the 70th week of Daniel, the time of Jacob's trouble, Jehovah's strange work. That's just a few of the names given in the Old Testament for the tribulation period. So, brothers and sisters, what I'm telling you is that it's time that the Israelis are coming to Jesus. You know, so we, the church, who 99% Gentiles, Goyim, it's reversed. We, the disciples, are going to praying to the Lord. Lord, there's some Israelis, there's some Jews who are here to see you. They want to know you. And so now, just as the Lord travailed in those days, when the Grecians, the Goyim, the Gentiles came to see him, he travailed because it was the time for his crucifixion. Now, the earth is in travail because it's time for the Lord's return. It's time for the church to depart out of this world. The true bride, the true church, and the true bride of the living God, hallelujah, of the Lord Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach, us, his bride, are about to depart out of the world, brothers and sisters, in a reverse of what happened 2,000 years ago. Now, in my mind, I'm hesitating because I'm thinking of the other message that the Lord gave me. And I always make my videos long. I'm going to cut this off, brothers and sisters, and come back, Lord willing, and make the second video of the other word that the Lord gave me. I can't even remember what it is, what I started to say when I started this video. I got to pray about it for a minute. God bless you guys. I'll be right back.